Controversial comments from Senator Mike Braun amidst a heated Supreme Court confirmation. We'll have the latest from D.C., plus the governor vetoes the transgender sports bill, but signs the bill getting rid of gun permits. We'll hear from an Indiana sheriff and from the ACLU of Indiana. It's all ahead right now on this week's edition of In Focus. It was a heated confirmation hearing for the president's historic Supreme Court nominee, but it was an Indiana senator making national news in the midst of that confirmation fight because of his comments on interracial marriage that he later tried to walk back. We'll have much more on Senator Braun's controversial remarks coming up. But we start today at the State House and a pretty noteworthy veto from Governor Holcomb this week on the transgender sports bill. Kristen Eskow has the latest on that bill and another controversial piece of legislation that the governor did sign into law.
The governor vetoed one controversial bill, the transgender athletes bill, and signed another that would allow many Hoosiers age 18 and older to carry handguns without a permit. On the permitless carry bill, the governor said in a statement that this bill, quote, entrusts Hoosiers who can lawfully carry a handgun to responsibly do so within our state. He goes on to point out the law does not apply to those who can't get a gun right now, including convicted felons or anyone deemed mentally unfit. Now, during the session, opponents had argued that the bill would make Hoosiers less safe. One of the most vocal opponents was State Police Superintendent Doug Carter. In a statement earlier, he said, quote, I will work with law enforcement leaders across our state to make necessary changes to firearms enforcement, as well as finding the best way to identify individuals who are not allowed to carry a firearm. Now, that law goes into effect July 1st. The governor also vetoed a bill that would have banned transgender girls from playing girls' school sports. In a letter to the State House, he said the bill could create confusion and students could be treated differently depending on which school they attend or compete for. 9-year-old Kieran Clausen is excited for her first day of soccer practice in Bloomington. It's one of several sports she plays.
I've made friends with almost all the teammates I've had since I was like 4.
Kieran is transgender and plays on girls' teams now. She'd be limited in the future if the bill banning transgender girls from playing girls' school sports becomes law. Republican Indiana lawmakers may override the governor's veto. Kieran's father testified against the bill twice.
She's really done great, and so there hasn't been any issues that we've ever had.
While parents who support the bill couldn't speak with us today, several testified this session, arguing the bill ensures girls have a fair opportunity to compete. In a letter to lawmakers, Governor Eric Holcomb argued he found no evidence girls are being put at any unfair disadvantage right now. Indiana House Speaker Todd Houston disagreed in a statement, saying, quote, this issue continues to be in the national spotlight and for good reason, as women have worked hard for equal opportunities on the playing field. And that's exactly what they deserve. Advocates applaud the House Republicans' response.
I think what we see is how quickly it only takes one male competing in a female category to quickly dominate. And that's why we need to take these proactive measures.
Meanwhile, Nathaniel Clausen hopes the governor's veto stands.
If you're really worried about this, let the IHSAA handle it the way they have been, because it hasn't been a problem.
From the Indiana State House, I'm Kristen Eskow.
All right, Kristen, thank you. We did reach out to the ACLU after Governor Holcomb vetoed the bill. They call the move a victory for transgender youth, but they say they realize they could still face an uphill battle when the legislature brings that bill back in May.
Our message is that you belong. You belong here. You should be treated just as your friends do. You should be able to have all the opportunities that your friends have. And even if this law somehow gets put into place, that the ACLU is going to do everything we can to make sure it never comes into effect and that we protect trans kids by all means possible.
Now, Governor Holcomb, by the way, joined Utah's governor who vetoed a similar bill dealing with transgender athletes. As we said earlier, while the governor vetoed that bill, he did sign into law another controversial measure that drew scrutiny at the State House, the legislation that essentially does away with gun permits for most Hoosiers. A lot of reaction from the law enforcement community. The state police superintendent opposed that bill. Also this week, we heard from the sheriff in Vandenberg County down in Evansville. He explained some of the complications they may face when that law takes effect in July.
For law enforcement, now if you have maybe 3 people who shouldn't possess a weapon inside a vehicle, and they get stopped by police and there is a weapon, they can have some young person, 18-year-old person, car and just claim, hey, those are my guns.
Now, on that bill, Attorney General Todd Rokita said we'll defend any attacks on constitutional carry and remain committed not only to the right to defend ourselves and our families, but to the great women and men of law enforcement statewide. He said the governor was correct to sign this manifestation of our God-given Second Amendment rights into code, in his words, and should be recognized for that. But on the transgender sports bill, Rokita said, quote, we stand by this law and will vigorously defend it in court if and hopefully when the General Assembly overrides the veto. CPAC wrote this letter to the governor saying, while we appreciate your strong record on pro-life and Second Amendment issues, this veto on transgender sports stands out, in their words, as a stain on your record. Senator Mike Braun also weighing in on the veto of the transgender sports bill saying, girls sports should be for girls. I'm disappointed Governor Holcomb vetoed a bill to make this law in Indiana, and I support a veto override to protect women's athletics.